In this video, we will describe Golden Gate cloning. Golden Gate cloning is a cloning technique that exploits unique features of type IIS restriction enzymes. Type IIS restriction enzymes are characterized by cleaving outside of their recognition sequence. The sequence present at the cleavage site is determined based only on its location relative to the recognition sequence. BSA1 is a type IIS restriction enzyme commonly used in Golden Gate cloning. This image from SnapGene shows you its recognition sequence in gray. Reading from the 5' end of the lower strand, it is GGTCTC. Shown in red is the 4 base pair overhang. Since cleavage occurs at a set distance from the recognition sequence for each type IIS restriction enzyme, the composition of the overhang can vary from cleavage site to cleavage site. In the case of a type IIS enzyme with a 4 base pair overhang, there are 256 possible overhangs associated with a single recognition site. Therefore, mere cleavage by a particular type IIS enzyme does not guarantee compatible ends. The only way to guarantee compatible ends is to design them into your cloning strategy. Golden Gate cloning was first described by Engler et al. In 2008. It is described as a one-pot, one-step, precision cloning method, where, as you will see, restriction enzyme and ligase are co-incubated. In developing and describing their system, the authors chose to reuse some of the terms used for gateway cloning. These are entry vector, entry clone, destination vector, and expression clone. Functionally, these elements have the same purpose. Both gateway and golden gate are designed for the modular assembly of genetic material into a complex clone for protein or gene expression. The entry vector is used to capture a gene fragment of interest to create an entry clone. In most cases, you will need to build several entry clones. These will be your building blocks for your final expression clone constructs. In order to create your final expression clone, a subset of your various entry clones will be used to provide insert material. Let's take a look at a specific example to see how this can work. In this image from the PLOS One Engler paper, you can see all of the components of the Golden Gate system. The researchers have built 3 entry clones. Each entry clone has a gene fragment of interest flanked by BSA1 sites. The entry clones are named PES, PEGFP3, and PEH. The BSA1 recognition sites are indicated by the letter B, and the specific overhang associated with each BSA1 cleavage site is shown highlighted in pink. Not all of the overhangs are compatible with each other, but by design, the overhangs have been engineered to align the fragments in a particular order. The final BSA1 engineered overhangs required to form an intact circular plasmid are found in the destination vector, PX, lac Z. Ligation results in the fragments being introduced in a predetermined order in the destination vector. If necessary, take a minute to go back and match the various overhangs so that you can see how they result in the finished product, our expression clone, PXSGFPH. The final technical detail to appreciate is that the BSA1 recognition site is always external to the cleavage site relative to how the fragments will be ligated. As a result, there are no remaining BSA1 sites in the finished product. The practical application to this is that all entry clones and the destination vector can be combined with ligase and BSA1 simultaneously. Any remaining linearized DNA will not be able to successfully transform bacteria, so generally there are no background colonies observed. No doubt, considerable time must be put into planning a Golden Gate cloning strategy. There are families of entry vectors to help you align your Golden Gate fragments, but it is essential to review the fragments you are cloning to make sure there are no internal BSA1 sites that will interfere with your desired clone. If detected, these BSA1 sites must be removed with site-directed mutagenesis. With proper design, Golden Gate cloning can assemble as many as 35 fragments in this seamless, scarless fashion.
To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.